And let's go across to someone who's leading the legal charge now of the Congress government there, Congress JDS government, Abhishek Manu Singhvi joining us. Appreciate your staying with us, Dr. Singhvi. I want to ask you, are you buying time? It appears to me that the Congress is desperately buying time. That's all you have at the moment. The governor was supposed to do the trust vote by Friday night. He has ignored the governor's directive. We have to wait till Monday.
Rajdeep, there's an old saying, ask the wrong question, you'll get the wrong answer. Mm-hmm. First of all, a small clarification. I'm for the speaker. I'm not for the government of the chief minister. So I will speak partly on the political part without being a counsel. When I have to be a counsel, I'll speak as a counsel. I don't want the roles to be mixed up. Now, I said, ask the wrong question, get the wrong answer. The session started yesterday, Rajdeep. And it's really important because when you talk in programs like yours, there's no shouting. You must understand this, your viewers. Give me half a minute or 1 minute. Session started yesterday. Session is going on yesterday. Session is going on the whole of today. Next working day is Monday. The session is ongoing. Nobody has aborted a session. Vote is held at the end of a session, not in the middle, not in the beginning. So that's point one. It is being projected as if there is an aborted session not being held. Number two, The governor, and I'm speaking as a constitutional lawyer, I mean, you can discount the fact that I'm a congressman, but you can ask anybody. This governor has absolutely no right to give any direction of any kind to anyone on an ongoing session. Consider that Parliament is having a session tomorrow, Rajdeep, and it is going on day to day because the session has to end when the speeches end. Now, the President of India,
Dr. Singhvi, you're saying I'm not asking the right question. Let me ask you the right question. You are the counsel for the Speaker. The Speaker is dealing the trust vote.
There is no power. So there's no... How? There are speeches going on. He will have the vote at the end of the session. It may be a vote on Monday. It may be a vote on Tuesday morning. How can the governor, tell me one thing, The question of flouting arises if the governor has any power to give. So they have written a letter to the governor saying you have no power to give a direction to an ongoing assembly session. Have you ever heard of a governor saying a ongoing assembly session have a vote today and not tomorrow? The vote will be held. Everybody is saying so. I am saying so. The speaker is saying so. The government is saying so. Now, suppose 10 people are giving speeches, the vote will be held immediately in the middle. And what is so great, the next working day is Monday. This is all an ignorance of constitutional law. The judiciary is supreme.
The truth is, you are going to use this weekend. You are hoping that the governor now dismisses the government and thereby you go in for fresh elections, or you are hoping that over this weekend you can get some of your MLAs to return. What is the truth?
So I control this. Okay, let me answer. Let me answer that because we have to be logical. So first question, I'm hoping we have a 356. So my hopes are to be awarded by a central government. The central government is in my control. The central government listens to me. The central government acts at my beck and corner and fulfills my hopes. Point number one answered. Point number two, if we have no numbers for so many days, how will the magical numbers come on the weekend? I have been open, Rajdeep. If on Tuesday when the trust vote is there, if on Wednesday evening when the trust vote is there, if on Monday evening when the trust vote is there, if we don't have the numbers, the government must go. If the BJP doesn't have the numbers, they must not form the government. What is so great about in democracy, the numbers are all that matter ultimately.
So you are...
But what you are saying is not numbers. You are saying let the discussion not end, have a vote. I don't understand who advised the governor. Can a governor be advised to say have a vote at 1:30 in the afternoon? Have a vote at 5:30. So it's a perfectly right thing the House is doing, the Speaker is doing, the government is doing, saying...
Because the governor has the suspicion... The governor has the suspicion that the Speaker is dealing on a matter which requires, according to the Supreme Court, should take place forthwith.
Who said that? Where the Supreme Court said that? And a suspicion of the Speaker does not convert constitutional law that he starts giving a direction to abort a discussion and have a vote. It's bizarre. As a matter of fact, Rajdeep, the Speaker is compromising his position. He's being shown in a very poor light. He's been shown as a person who's been misadvised in constitutional law. He's been shown as a person who's following that wrong advice. He's been shown as partisan. He's been shown as an agent of the central government, because the Speaker knows very, the governor knows very well that he has no power to do this. Yes, if the discussion in the House was aborted, if the House was adjourned sine die, if there was no House ongoing, then okay, you could say this. Now, how does it matter if the vote is on Monday or Tuesday?
Okay,
please
we will
tell
wait.
Me how it matters.
Okay.
And because the vote is not to your liking on Wednesday, you, the Speaker, will give it, you, the Governor, will give a direction to have it on Tuesday.
Okay. Dr. Singhvi.
Just consider, you are not a constitutional lawyer.
Does Dr. Singhvi, you've made your
tell
point
me a single
very.
Single provision of the Constitution. You've tell made, me a single judgment which yes. says the Governor can say, Mr. Speaker, have a vote.
Okay. Dr. Singhvi, you've made your point very strongly. I appreciate your
Thank
joining
you.
Us. You're assuring us that if the government doesn't have the votes, Thank the trust vote A will take place. And if the government doesn't have the vote, Mr. Kumaraswamy will go away quietly. Thanks very
it
much.
It must go.
Okay.
It must go.
Okay. Thanks very much for joining me. Dr. Singhvi there. Let's then turn...
As and when the trust...
Let's turn to the big questions tonight. Is there a constitutional crisis now brewing in Karnataka? Can the governor be setting deadlines to the Speaker? Why is the Speaker openly defying the governor? Are the Congress JDS effectively...